Melek here again for another Minecraft vid. This is not part of the Let's Play. This is basically a how-to. It's an update for the underwater how-to that I did a long time ago, the one that was pitch black for most of the time. What I'm actually doing here is I've got a little bit more light just so that you can see what the hell is going on. So I'm just going to keep breathing. Important to remember that. Now, as before, we start by putting out some soil, making sure that it's basically the shape of the dome that you want to build. Obviously this isn't going to be quite exactly the same because I've got a limited amount of space to build in, but it should be alright. And it's quite shallow here as well, so it's going to be easier to build, although not necessarily exactly the same as how you'll do it when you build it yourself. But it'll be a good little demonstration on how to do it yourself. Okay, so shallow in fact that now I can breathe pretty easily. Okay, now this dome's slightly bigger than the other one. It's still 3 blocks high, but it's now 4 width and 4 length. So my domes tend to be a little bit bigger these days. So anyway, I'm just taking another breath. Okay, first things first. Make a nice little wall around it. Now it's up to you whether you want to miss the corners. They're not needed, but it's up to you whether you want that kind of extra bit. Although saying that, I did seem to get this corner. Okay, and finally we put the glass in place, and as you can see I've been busy and I've gotten quite a lot of glass. And it's really up to you how you go about putting the glass in place. One way is as good as any other. Finally, put it at the top. Not much of an underwater dome, but it will do, as you can see. It probably won't look quite as good from the inside because it's in such shallow water, but it'll do, it'll do. And then finally, we dig underneath. Now, I might end up putting out half the torches that illuminate the underneath, but I will try my best to avoid that. Just gonna get my spade ready. Okay. Okay, here we go. Water's flooded underneath. Now, normally this would all be, of course, dirt and gravel and whatnot. So you'll have to forgive me for the fact that it's not. So, pretend all the floor that's glass. Just pretend. Just pretend that it's soil. So then we hollow out the insides. And the brilliant thing about the new water physics is that they are much more forgiving, as you could see. I opened up a big hole in the bottom and it didn't completely flood the cave, so that's a good thing for building underwater domes. Because if I do happen to accidentally puncture the top of the dome, it won't completely flood the area. In this particular case, because there's no water directly above. But let's say I accidentally puncture a bit of water there. Whoa, we end up getting flooded inside. Whoa. So then, luckily, it's not even flooded completely. So we end up rushing in there, plugging the hole, and then it all dries up. Absolutely fantastic. Now, the next bit is to make a little corridor, because you want to be able to join these domes up. Now, I didn't think ahead, because now these little torch pods that I created are in the way. But we can sort this out. Okay, that is where I'm going to dig. Now I'm going to use a slightly different tactic this time. And it's basically called the crude way of doing it. All I'm going to do is dig like that. And gradually work my way forward. And every now and again you will get it so that you can't quite get a roof on. But every now and again it should dry up, as you can see. Job done. Another way you can do it, instead of gradually doing it, is you can literally just completely go outside. Now it is a bit trickier, because obviously you keep getting pushed around. I mean, I'm fighting the current right now, trying to do this. As you can see, you can have quite a lot of water gushing in and actually not risk flooding the dome. And so you'll have to forgive my very crude method this time around. Now, once you've gotten a certain amount of flooding, you'll notice now that the water's staying there. Even though, if I swim into it, it's completely sealed. That's because it's got an infinite water pod somewhere. A little tile that's full of infinite water. So you just, again, fill it full of soil. Job done. Right. There we have the basics of the dome. We don't need the soil, pretend soil floor. So I'm just gonna fill that in. Of course you could leave the glass floor in and dig another room underneath. That's completely up to you. But there you go. Now we have a dome. We have the beginnings of another tunnel leading to another future dome. And hey presto. Now, as far as airlocks and the like go, they can be a little bit trickier. Nowadays I tend to go for a bit of what's called a moon pool, which is basically a tunnel that's like a U-shape. So you go down here, across, and then up outside, and the level of the water stays constant. But have a check of my underwater home number 3 in my videos, and you will see one of those in action, and they're pretty straightforward to build. Have a go. And for that, I will leave it at that. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Hope it's a little bit better than the other one. And catch you next time.